Urbanized and growing areas lead in containing dense concentrations of particulate matter due to large emissions from the great number of fuel-powered vehicles and people making a life in the city. The urban areas lack vegetation cover that naturally cleans up the air. According to Kampala City Mayor Erias Lukwago, the city cripples by 5 times worse off the World Health Organization standard. Lukwago has highlighted the need for an urgent solution.
What worries me the more? It's business as usual. People are not bothered. We are seated here, but not everybody outside there is bothered. You get it? That means there is some missing link somewhere. Hence the notion, if it is for us, then involve us.
As per the data from various quality monitors around Kampala, the breathable air is seen to contain 25 particles units away from the ideal scale, not exceeding 5. Lukwago thus urged all stakeholders to join in the campaign to plant an urban forest to help bring down the concentrations.
Population explosion in Kampala. Honestly speaking, it is a time bomb we are sitting on. Whoever comes to Kampala doesn't want to go back. They are all here. One-way traffic, the buses, the taxis, ferrying these days, even border borders. All the way from Chisoro, they can come on a border border. Here in the Kampala. And it is projected by 2050, half of the population will be living in this in Kampala here. It's dangerous.
Dr. Rebecca Nantanda, a pediatrician at the Lung Institute in Mulago, says the effects have already been felt as current statistics show that 5 of every 10 pneumonia cases in children are air pollution related.
What most people don't appreciate is that the air you breathe, even though you're not seeing the smoke or you're not seeing the dust, as long as you're breathing, you're taking the toxic substances. You're going to affect your lungs. And for the pregnant mom, those substances go all the way to the uterus or the womb and affect the growth of the baby, including the baby's lungs. So we've been able to generate evidence to clearly show that air pollution is a problem right from the time you're conceived to the time that you pass on to the next world.
All this was discussed at Sheraton Hotel as Makerere University, in partnership with AIRCO, launched the Clean Air Africa Network campaign to closely monitor air quality across Africa and devise possible solutions.
Lagos, Bujumbura, and many others.
The Vice Chancellor of Makerere University, Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, connotes that the country cannot afford to wait any longer since the problem is already here. He adds that in the long run, it will impact the economics if not worked on.
Air pollution has also aggravated effects like climate change. These effects have equally threatened our economic sustainability. And to assure you that our pollution is a real problem in Kampala, Lord Mayor, it is a real problem. The Makerere Lung Institute has reported a sharp increase in the number of patients with respiratory problems.
The U.S. Ambassador's representative pledged support to KCCA to fix emitting vehicles across the city.
Sharing data openly and transparently contributes to raising awareness about the importance of air quality and the impact of pollution on our health, like we've all talked about today in your plenary. And our focus will remain on enhancing the air quality monitoring and data management, increasing awareness of air quality issues, and supporting the implementation of the plans that you are developing here in cities across Africa. And we are confident that this will be a turning point for air quality management in Africa.
In the Project Air Quality, monitors are placed strategically across the country to keep giving real-time data of the state of the air, and in the launched campaign, this will be done all over the African continent. Report compiled by Dennis Chove for the news.